started.
And Cora. And Cora from Spain. Okay, let's see. How about a Sicilian? And I'll just play a normal Sicilian here. Takes. And knight f6 attacking the pawn. Knight c3 defending. And I could play the classical or the... let's try the dragon. I haven't played the dragon in a while. Okay, so he plays bishop e2. That's usually the more positional line. And then he plays f3. That's an unusual combination. You don't usually get to see bishop e2 and f3 together. Does that mean anything? I think with f3 there, it makes this move e5 a bit tempting. But let's develop the knight first. See what he's planning to do. He goes queen d2, yeah, so he's playing to castle queen side. And he can put pressure on the c pawn. So let's go here with a6. Okay, let's, I can exchange off this knight. Go for bishop e6. This is a different kind of setup you can use with a dragon. You're pointing your bishop at the a2 square, and then you also have the idea of pushing these pawns forward. So, pawn to b5 and queen to pawn to b4 and queen to a5 is something that could be considered. Okay, so he stops it up with the knight. Could I trade off that knight? Should I trade off that knight? Obviously I can do it. Or I could just retreat my bishop. The knight's not going anywhere great, is it? This is a good bishop, so let's keep it, and then I'll wait and see if I want to maintain this bishop as well. The knight is hitting e7. I should remember that. That's a soft spot in this setup. Because I sort of want to do something with my queen to threaten checkmate here on b2. But I have to be careful. Okay, so now if I play h4, he can play... If I play h5, he can play g4. Takes, takes, and his bishop is there to support it. If he plays... I'm going to try this move. h6. The idea is if he plays h5, I'll play g5. Try and keep things closed around the king here. So he's going for the, there's a soft spot on g6. And he's hitting my bishop at the same time. I don't necessarily want to waste time repositioning the bishop again. But if he takes the bishop, it weakens the g6 square because I have to take back with the pawn. Unless I could defend with the queen. And rook here, and queen somewhere on the c-file. So he's leaving it there. So the immediate queen over here is not happening because my pawn's in the way. If I were to move my pawn forward, he could just take it. let's get a rook on the c file. Maybe I could consider bishop to c4 here. Trade off his light squared bishop, which is a big help in this attack on the king side here. Okay, so he decided to trade it off. You know, if he trades queens, this is should be an okay setup for me. These advanced pawns sometimes turn into weaknesses. And I have an advanced pawn here, but I have a target on the c pawn, and we have opposite colored bishops. That might not be so great. Let's go here with the queen and then see what he does. He can't easily oppose it. He pushes a pawn, I take it. If he drops the queen back, I take here on g2, a checkmate. So he needs to play a move like f3. Then I can play rook to c5, hitting his queen, and double the rooks and maybe crash through. Maybe I don't even need to double the rooks. Okay, so he defends with the queen. So I am going to try and increase the pressure here on the c-file. You know, leaving my queen here, there's one drawback, which is if he pushes g5, forces open some lines here. A bit unfortunate. Okay, didn't play that. He played here, leaving his f-pawn undefended. Queen takes. He's got a rook here. And that could be annoying. Still, I should probably do that. Grab a couple of pawns and try and weather the storm here. It gets his rooks into great position. I have to say that. And let's see, if I go to there and he takes, then the g-pawn will be loose. So let's go all the way back here. Oh, he can still take. He can just take on g6 because this pawn is pinned by his queen. Yeah, he spotted that. Okay, so yeah, I have to block that diagonal, and he's got to retreat the rook, I hope. And then, you know, if I put my king over here on h7, his bishop is in the line of fire there. Maybe. Okay, I think I need to prepare a little bit. I need to be able to play rook to g8 if he doubles on the bishop here. If he plays rook to g1, ganging up on my poor bishop here. Actually, my bishop is still kind of pinned. If I move it, it's checkmate here in the back rank. Got to be careful of these little tricks here. Okay, he's defending his pawns. Try making a little more progress on my attack towards his king here. So this is going to open up a line. He's going to take back with the bishop if I take. Could I play pawn here first? Pawn to a4 hits the queen. The queen wants to stay in touch with this pawn, right? So it'll go to... it'll go to b4 or c3. And then here... and if the bishop takes, I can play... I can play d5 here, pinning the bishop, right? I have to check to make sure there's no tempo moves on the bishop. What he can do is move his queen here and attack my bishop instead of trying to defend his bishop. I can play f6 maybe, defending my bishop this way with the queen. Yeah, that's pretty good. And also hitting his rook. His rook can come forward to g6, or it can drop back to g4. I don't think taking works. Takes, queen takes, rook takes. Takes, king takes, and I'm ahead. Or he could just save his bishop here. I guess, yeah, if he moves his rook, I take the bishop. That's going to be the problem. If he saves his bishop, I take the rook. Maybe I've maybe I finally wiggled out of this one. And, well, I still have my idea of getting my queen on this diagonal and checkmating, but the queen is guarding. The queen guards the b2 square. But, yeah, white is in a tough spot here. Typically exciting Sicilian dragon game. I think the movie played bishop e2 was a bit of a tempo loss. Okay. I should just take again and renew the threat. I guess. His rook is still hanging and his bishop is still hanging, so we're still in this case where he's got two pieces hanging. Okay, he went for the grabbing the... he went for grabbing the rook. The bishop, rather. So queen takes, rook takes, king takes. I'll have rook against bishop and I'll have... two, three, four. Four pawns against three, plus a passer. So I think it's a winning endgame. Should get the full point this time. Yeah, so he's thinking about it. I don't know what he can play.
White resigns.
Okay, well, good game. I will upload this and do a postmortem. See you guys later. Bye.